The course is basically broken down into 5 sections. In section 1, we're just gonna get started with the course. You're gonna get a brief introduction to the course, you're gonna get the outline, you're gonna get the resources, and you're gonna understand the common problem that we all face as automation engineers when it comes to doing automated functional testing of the web. In the next section, you're gonna learn why record and replay automation is not effective. I'm gonna begin that section by actually recording a test for you and showing you that process. Afterwards, I'm gonna attempt to run the test. We're gonna fix the test to actually make it be able to run. We're gonna understand all of the disadvantages of record and replay, functional test automation, and all of the problems. And once we understand the problems, we're actually gonna be able to apply fixes to those problems to improve the recorded testing to make it more robust. In section 3, we're gonna begin learning the pitfalls of keyword-driven test automation. First, I'm gonna introduce you to keyword-driven testing, give you a brief introduction to what it is and what it looks like. Afterwards, we're gonna understand all of the disadvantages and problems with keyword-driven testing and why it does not allow our automated functional tests to be stable and robust like they should be. And of course, after we understand all the disadvantages and the problems, we can come up with logical solutions to those problems to further improve the stability of our automated functional tests. So in section 4, we're finally gonna start having some fun with page object pattern. I'm gonna begin by teaching you what are page objects, giving you a brief introduction, showing you what they look like and their properties. Afterwards, I'll teach you the advantages and disadvantages of those page objects. We're gonna implement page objects to fix our tests so that you can see why the page objects are the most efficient way to write automated functional tests. We're gonna write more tests using page objects because it's critical that you understand all the concepts here. We're gonna write lots of tests using page objects, and we're gonna reinforce the same concepts over and over. And then we'll get into the last section where we're gonna make our page objects even better. Yes, it's possible. First, I'm gonna teach you the DRY principle. Once you learn the DRY principle, we're gonna use the DRY principle to further improve our automated functional tests to make them even more resilient to changes. Afterwards, you're gonna learn the single responsibility principle. After learning and mastering the single responsibility principle, we're gonna implement it further on our tests so that you can see how the tests evolve with all of these techniques that we're learning to stabilize our tests. Finally, we're gonna learn how to deal with complex web pages because this is a very common problem when it comes to functional test automation. And so I wanna help you learn how to overcome it when inevitably you're gonna face it. And once you learn how to deal with complex web pages, of course, we're gonna improve our tests using that technique. And at the end of all of these sections, you're gonna have a phenomenal understanding of page objects. And not only are you gonna be able to understand page objects, you're gonna be able to write amazing page objects that can withstand the test of time. Now, let's go ahead and look at the prerequisites for the course. Yes, there are prerequisites for the course, and you definitely need to pay attention.